Welcome to a second video on surface area of revolution. I decided to go ahead and make a second video with rotation about the y-axis. Let's go ahead and first review our surface area formulas. Remember, we have a formula for rotation about the x-axis as we see here, and another one about the y-axis as we see here. Remember, in both cases we have an option for ds, which represents the arc length, meaning we can integrate with respect to x or with respect to y. But of course that will affect our limits of integration as well as how we express the radius. And that is true for both rotation about the x-axis and rotation about the y-axis. Let's go and take a look at our example. F of x equals the cube root of 8 on the interval from 0 to 8 along the x-axis. And we're going to rotate this about the y-axis, so in this direction here. And we want to find the surface area of this solid. So here's the formula for rotation about the y-axis. And for this example, let's go ahead and integrate with respect to y, which means we'll use the formula for surface area that would be 2 pi times the integral of g of y times the square root of 1 plus g prime of y squared with respect to y. So notice we have to express our radius and the function in terms of y. So what that means is we'll have to take this function here, y equals the cube root of x, and solve it for x. Let's go ahead and do that now. If we have y equals x to the power of 1/3, and we cube both sides of the equation, we'll have y cubed equals x. So using function notation, this tells us that g of y is equal to y cubed. And the derivative of g with respect to y would be equal to 3y squared. The only other information we need is the interval for y, since we're integrating with respect to y. So if x goes from 0 to 8, well, when x is 8, the cube root of 8 would be 2. The interval for y would be from 0 to 2. So let's go ahead and see if we can set this up. It's going to be equal to 2 pi times the definite interval from 0 to 2 of g of y, which would be the radius, meaning this distance here. But it has to be expressed in terms of y. That's going to be y cubed times the square root of 1 plus g prime of y squared. Well, g prime of y is 3y squared, so if we square this, we'll have 9y to the fourth with respect to y. Looking at this now, since the radicand is degree 4, and we have a degree 3 term here, that should key us into using u substitution, where u is going to equal 1 plus 9y to the fourth, so du would be equal to 36y to the third, dy. And notice that our integrand contains y cubed dy, so if we wanted a perfect match, we should divide both sides by 36. So we have u equals 1 plus 9y to the fourth, and 136 du is equal to y cubed dy. If we want to rewrite this now in terms of u, we'd have 2 pi y cubed dy will be replaced with 136th du. So we'll have the 136th here, and then we have our du, and here our radicand is equal to u, squared of u would be u to the 1/2. So let's go ahead and take this over to the next screen and continue. Let's go ahead and integrate with respect to u. Well, first this would be pi over 18. Then we'd have u to the 3/2 divided by 3/2. We'll leave off the plus c because this is going to be a definite integral in terms of x. Let's go ahead and clean this up and rewrite it in terms of x. So here we'd have pi over 18 times the reciprocal of 3/2. That would be 2/3. Well, pi over 18 times 2/3 times u to the 3/2, but u is 1 plus 9y to the fourth. We need to evaluate all of this at the upper and lower limits of 2 and 0. Let's go ahead and clean this up one more time. This would be 1, that would be 9. So we have pi over 27. Now we'll substitute 2 for y. And then substitute 0 for y. Well, 2 to the 4th would be 16, times 9 would be 144, plus 1, 145 to the 3 halves power, minus, over here we'd have 1 plus 0 to the 3 halves, that would just be 1. And I'll go ahead and leave it like this, but let's go ahead and get a decimal approximation. And that's approximately 203.04, and this would be square units for a surface area. And that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found it helpful.